Yo, what's up everyone? This is Silver Slayer. Thanks for tuning in. Today we are talking about the 10 rules of silver investing. This is actually a real list that people abide by. These are rules that people abide by. It was actually created by silver enthusiast David Morgan. The link will be in the description if you want to check this out for yourself, but it's really interesting. It's a very, very educational article. You guys are definitely going to enjoy this, so make sure to smash that like button. Subscribe if you already haven't, because I do post daily videos. So anyways, let's jump into it. A long time ago, fellow silver enthusiast David Morgan, for whom I have great respect, came up with this list of his 10 rules for silver investing. I have used his excellent thoughts, added a few different ideas, and a few of my own updates, and I'm sharing them here. Don't think of these as hard set rules in stone that must never be broken, but more of a guideline to keep you pointed in the right direction in this volatile silver market, which is a great introduction. I also want to mention up here, it says, gold is the money of kings, silver is the money of gentlemen, barter is the money of peasants, and debt is the money of slaves. I thought that was pretty cool, pretty interesting. You know, we're gentlemen around here, if you know what I'm saying. But anyways, let's jump into rule number one. Always take physical delivery. So, by the way, I'm not going to read all the fine details. I'm going to skim over a lot of it for the timely matter of this video. But I'm going to highlight the main points. And this is talking about physical delivery. Paper ETFs like the SOV Silver Fund are run by the very bank JP Morgan that is criminally manipulating silver markets. Holding paper silver will do you no good at all in an SHTF scenario. The people of Zimbabwe are forced to pan for gold in the rivers to obtain enough money each day to eat, just to eat and survive. Their paper dollars have been inflated, such as a $100 trillion note wouldn't even buy you a loaf of bread, which I've talked about in several different videos, how their money is so pumped and so impregnated that they have to carry their money in trash bags. At the cash registers, they actually weigh their money on scales because it has the purchasing power of like a penny, like a dollar bill. So to buy a candy bar or a loaf of bread, you would have to literally weigh your money because it would take too long to count. So, he goes into saying the market vendors would only accept gold and silver in exchange for goods. You must take physical delivery of your metals to hold up silver on its own. So he's talking about the physical asset. Always buy physical precious metals. If it's on an online exchange or a paper silver, like silver ETFs, I actually just made a video yesterday talking about why I don't buy or I don't invest in silver ETFs. I think the physical precious metal has many more beneficial factors, as well as much more potential when you're looking at market demand, supply, digging it out the ground, turning them into bullion coins. You know, it's very, very, there's just more potential, and it makes more sense by far, in my opinion, because ETFs are the same thing as fiat currency pegged to a digital asset, a currency. But anyways, rule number two is don't overpay for your silver. Remember, silver and gold are fungible and traded based upon their weight in pure metal. A tarnished and scratched up old silver round is worth as much as one brilliant uncirculated mint condition once they hit the melting point pot or a refiner. So he's saying that, which I actually mentioned sometimes, he's saying that, you know, silver is silver. And this is coming from the perspective of your local coin shops and people who just look at silver for the metal content, that they're saying brilliant uncirculated condition really doesn't matter. They're all getting melted down. And as long as the weight of that silver is 1 ounce, you should be paying as close to spot as possible, which is true in some circumstances, depending on which type of silver stacker you are. If you're a quick flipper, if you're buying these coins on eBay, looking for semi-numismatic value and flipping them for collector value and collecting every year these sets and series, then you can make money. But if you're just a silver stacker looking at or investing in silver for the metal content because you see the potential in its metal form, then yes, silver is silver, and you want to be getting as much silver for as cheap as possible. So this is, you know, it really is idealistic depending on your perspective, your future goals, and the direction you want to go. You know, so this is a good rule, though. You know, sometimes if you are paying these high premiums for pandas and coins like that, you know, you might not get the same in returns, especially depending on where you sell from. But anyways, rule number three, start small, keep it simple. This is something that I've mentioned a lot before. It can be extremely overwhelming jumping into the world of precious metals. There's so many different coins. There's so many different options, so many different ways to go, so many places to buy from. keep it simple, you know, really just educate yourself, watch YouTube videos, you know, find out which direction you want to go and start from there, learn how to budget your money. So rule number four, be careful buying at all-time highs. This is especially a very important rule to look out for right now as we see gold above 1500 and we see silver breaking 1700, I mean $17, sorry. As we see silver breaking $17, you know, there's covering a lot of media attention. Everyone's talking about it, so it drives a lot of people into the precious metals world, and a lot of people want to start buying silver and gold because they hear about it. But only thing is, they're buying right now while the prices are as highest. You know, usually you want to buy low and sell high, not buy high and then have to sell low. So be careful when you are buying at these high peaks right now. Usually you should be selling your silver right now or holding on to it or trading your silver for gold or gold for silver, vice versa. Anyways, rule number five, learn how to avoid fake silver. This is something I've definitely made a lot of videos about. There's several different ways to avoid fake silver. The best tip I could give you guys is just buy from trusted dealers like APMEX, Provident Metals, Modern Coin Mart, JM Bullion. You know, there's several places that are legit bullion dealers, you know, billion dollar companies that have legit silver. But if you are, you know, buying silver from places like eBay or maybe even your local coin shop, sometimes you just want to make sure that your silver is real. There's silver testing kits, you know, there's different types of ways. There's the magnets, there's the magnet tip. You can do the water deplacement thing or whatever. I don't know what it's called actually. They have the actual like machines, the silver testing machines. So there's different things you can do to secure yourself and protect yourself from fake silver. And if this is something that you do, if you barter with a lot of people or if you buy off a lot of places that aren't, you know, trusted sellers, I definitely recommend at least having a silver testing kit just to make sure. You know, it's something I cannot stress enough because especially when it comes to the precious metals market, some of these coins can be a lot of money and it would be terrible to have to pay this money and get scammed out of a coin. Anyways, rule number six, a little information can mean a lot more silver, and this is definitely true. Just like something going along the lines of learning what the gold to silver ratio is and learning how to buy and sell or trade those coins at the right time. You can make a lot of free gold or free silver just by simply selling or trading your silver for gold or trading your gold for silver at certain times in the market. You can go it, you can learn you can earn lots and lots of silver. But also as far as along the lines of learning that the JM Bullion has the beginner silver starting kit for 10 ounces of silver at spot price. If you know people that don't know about that are missing out on that opportunity, and that's 10 ounces of silver that can lower your dollar per cost average. It can help you a long way. So a little information can mean a lot more silver. Anyways, rule number seven, what's yours is yours, so keep it that way. This is an important topic. He goes on to say, while it's wise to keep some of your silver where you can get to it easily, it's also important to keep the bulk of your metal in a safe place. And that's definitely true. Also, be careful who you're telling. Actually, one of the main reasons I started my channel is because I couldn't tell people in person that I know that I have my silver, and it was exciting, and I wanted to talk about it. So the only way I really could was talk to people online about it and do unboxings, because talking to people in person, they might not always have the best intentions, or maybe the person you tell has the best intentions, but someone they might tell might not. So just be very careful with that. You know, silver storage and security is a huge thing that I stress a lot on my channel. Rule number eight, hedge your metal stack with mining stocks. This is one I'm not really too I'm not too pro on, but it can be very beneficial to some people, whatever works for you. This is something I personally don't do, but if you can find beneficial factors in it or profits in it, then that's, you know, it's amazing. Then do go for it, you know. But he goes on to say, once you've built your insurance stack of silver, also secured your core metal position, then you are in stacking mode. You should be slowly buying silver to add to your core position, dollar cost averaging over time, keeping spare cash reserves for unexpected expenses. If he's okay, so he's meaning it in a different mind state than I was, you know, originally intended. This gives your metals portfolio some diversifications and potential for explosive gains as the stocks are highly leveraged. So that's definitely something that I push more now than I did before. I would always mention, you know, when it came to diversification, I was more pro like pandas. Now I'm seeing the beneficial sides of all angles in precious metals, whether it's bullion, semi-numismatics, even numismatics. They all do have beneficial properties to them, whether, you know, bullion can protect yourself from, you know, damaged coins or having to risk the condition of the coins being ruined. And then also numismatic coins have the beneficial properties of protecting yourself against spot price. You know, if spot price stays low, then at least your coins will still appreciate and over time with value. But also, you know, there's other parts to it as well. He goes on to say the eggs in one basket quote, which is definitely something that I recommend. Anyways, let's go into rule number 9. Know when to sell your silver. This is probably the most important, you know, rule, because it's so easy to buy silver, but a lot of us don't think about how we're going to sell it. And if we're not thinking about how we're going to sell our silver, we're setting ourselves up. And you know, selling your silver can become a full-time job. You want to make sure that you're thinking about these coins. You know, when you're about to buy them, you know, think about how you're going to sell it. Will you sell it online? Are you going to sell it to your local coin shop? Are you going to keep it forever? You know, how much, how, what's, when's the price range you think this coin is going to be able to, you know, appreciate from, whether it's 5 years down the line, 10 years down the line? And do you have that patience? You know, a lot of times people aren't as patient and don't have the resources to sell their coins. You know, sometimes you don't have local coin shops right down the road from your house that you can just go sell your silver at. But then you're gonna have to build a business, meaning you're gonna have to sell them on eBay or and even maybe even places like AppMex. And if you're gonna do that, are your coins still gonna be profitable? You know, that's stuff to think about. But anyways, rule number 10, when all else fails, there is silver. And he goes on to say, no one likes to be a prophet of doom, but the simple truth is silver's world's money is the last resort. Should a severe economic collapse occur, leaving paper assets worthless, silver will be primary currency. And I definitely think that's true. I made a video yesterday also talking about silver and the economic collapse and the financial crisis and how beneficial it can be, and how I definitely think everyone needs to be taking part of this. And also, I think the longer that our financial system goes, you know, unsolved or unresolved, I think people are going to be driving towards silver more and more. Anytime when there's a financial crisis or, you know, a recession or anything happens in the economy where people don't trust banks or governments, they're always turning to gold and silver because they are the one safe form of wealth that you can control in your own, you know, your own wealth and your own will. And that's definitely something I think a lot of people find value in. Silver and gold are intrinsic valued coins and investments. And I think more people are finally starting to get the gist of this every single day. And that's really good news for us silver stackers, because we know it, you know, we just need other people to catch the grip along. And I think it's starting to finally happen, and it's going to be happening more and more. But anyways, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. If you did, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe if you already have, and I post daily videos. I've actually been posting 2 to 3 videos a day, so stay tuned, check out all those other ones. I've been making some really good videos lately, some of my best content. I know you guys are going to enjoy them, and thanks for tuning in. This was Silver Slayer. I'll see you guys soon. Peace.